Starliner's planned one-week stay at the ISS has been extended once again. NASA is using the extra time to go over issues that happened during the flight. West 2's Spencer Tracy explains the importance of doing so.
Eventually, obviously, it's time to come home. We all know that. But yeah, a little more time would be great.
Starliner's first crew mission will be extending their stay at the International Space Station.
I think a lot of us don't look at that as a delay. We look at that as an opportunity and in this case, privilege to stay on station and do more work.
The new target date is June 26th at the White Sands Space Harbor in New Mexico. NASA says the spacecraft encountered 5 helium leaks and thruster malfunctions. Over the weekend, crews performed a hot fire test. One of the thrusters acted up and will remain off during the return trip. NASA says they are gearing up for a safe return.
And what we're doing on the helium leaks is now looking at what's left in the remainder of the flight. We need about 7 hours of helium, and we have about 70 hours of margin.
We asked Professor Don Platt from Florida Tech about the importance of having working thrusters on the spacecraft.
And so they are so critical that they have redundancy. And so if one fails, then there are others that can pick up for it and complete that process.
NASA says they gave their team off this weekend for some much needed rest. They originally were supposed to land on June 22nd, but they say this delay will help them analyze data and land safely.
This is a test vehicle and there's no reason to not fully understand the situation before they bring the people home. They're safe there on the space station.
NASA says they are confident in getting astronauts Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams safely back home. In Brevard County, Spencer Tracy, West 2 News.
Now, aside from the technical issues, NASA says the mission has satisfied 77 of the original 87 flight test objectives. They'll evaluate the remaining 10 during undocking and landing.